Number four. We have x double prime plus 8x prime plus 15x, and that is equal to 0. X of 0 is 0, and x prime of 0 is negative 3. Do I put 0? Got a little carried away with my zeros there. Okay. 2 will make the problem more interesting. Okay. So we take the Laplace of each piece. So let's start with the x double prime. What are we going to have? Sam did it last time, so somebody besides Sam has to do it this time. Or I'll make Sam carry the whole class. Not fair.
S squared.
Okay, we start with S squared.
Laplace x minus SX 2.
X of 0. We're going to put a 2 in place of x of 0 in a minute.
Okay.
Keep going.
And then minus prime, I guess, 0.
Well, x prime of 0, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Okay, now let's move over. Veronica's off the hook because she did the first one. Sam's off the hook because he did the last problem. So somebody else has to do 8x prime. Maylene looks like she wants to do it.
No.
She was looking like she was thinking hard. What do you think, Maylene? You can look back on page 277 for a hint. What are we doing? It's x prime. Laplace of x. Okay, that's part of it.
Minus 8s.
Yeah, we have to distribute that 8. Okay. And then we still have our plus 15 Laplace of x. And on the other side, we have the Laplace of 0. Okay, so let's see what we can group. We get an s squared plus 8s plus 15 with our Laplace. Does that look like a characteristic equation? Yeah, so that's good. Now, when we get to the s times x of 0, our x of 0 was 2. So this term right here is going to become a minus 2s. What about this one?
Plus 3.
That becomes a plus 3 because we had minus and negative. All right, and then this one becomes a minus 16. What's the Laplace of 0?
0.
So we're going to have our s squared plus 8s plus 15 Laplace of x. We're going to move everything else to the other side. So on the other side, we'll have a positive 2s. And a positive 13. Because when we move things to the other side, they change sign. And then we're going to divide. So this is going to give us 2s plus 13 all over s squared plus 8s. Plus 15. Now, get caught up writing. Let me stop there just a minute, and you tell me if you have any questions so far about what we've done on this problem. Any questions so far? Do you understand where all this came from? So now we're back to partial fractions again. We're going to take this, and we're going to break it up. How would we factor?
X plus 5.
S plus 5. S plus 3. And we'll just call this one A, and this one B. And we're going to take this whole thing, and we're going to multiply by S plus 5, S plus 3. So we're going to end up here with 2s plus 13 is equal to a times s plus 3 plus b times s plus 5. AS plus 3A plus BS plus 5B. So that's going to become A plus B with S. And then our constant terms will be 3A plus 5B. So we know that A plus B has to equal, what?
2.
And then 3A plus 5B equals 13. And then our options are, we can do the addition method or elimination. We can do substitution. We can graph it and see where the points intersect. We can do matrices. What do you think here? Keep it as easy as you can. That's probably going to be the quickest way to get this one done.
Elimination.
Probably elimination. So let's multiply here by negative. I don't know. Let's do the 5 and get rid of the B first. You want to get rid of the A first? That's okay too. So we're going to have negative 5A minus 5B. Is equal to negative 10. And then on the bottom we have 3a plus 5b equals 13. So we get negative 2a equals 3. So a is negative 3 halves. If a plus b is 2, that'd be 4 halves. So B is going to be 7 halves, right? Okay, so that means then that our Laplace transform is going to be negative 3 halves over S plus 5. Plus 7 halves over S plus 3. Now flip to your Laplace table. And I would say, I would write this one. I would pull out my negative 3 halves. And I would change my S plus 5 to S minus a negative 5. And I do that because that looks more like what's in the table. And you're trying to make it match what's in the table. So if you were to go to your Laplace table and you look at the form that we've got, what would you tell me your answer would be here? 3 halves times what?
E to the negative 5.
E to the negative 5t, okay. Any questions about where this came from?
Is it negative 3?
It is a negative 3. Any questions? Now, look back to your characteristic equation for just a minute. You had s squared plus 8s plus 15. The roots of that equation would be real numbers, right? Two distinct real numbers. So does it make sense to get a solution that's in terms of e?
Yeah.
So is this a technique clear so far? The process? Okay. Now let's talk about what to do if they throw an extra variable in there, because sometimes they do. So I want you to look at problem number 12.